In this video, we'll take a look at a second example involving correlation in SPSS. And on your screen, you can see two variables. We have height, which is the height of individuals in inches, and then we have weight, which is reported in pounds. And what we have in this example is, notice there are 20 people, and for each person, their height and weight was recorded. So for example, the first person has a height of 60 inches, or 5 feet, and a weight of 135 pounds. Second person is 64 inches and 145 pounds, and so on. Okay, so we'll run the correlation coefficient in SPSS in just a moment, but I'd like to, before we do that, let's go ahead and use an alpha of 0.01 in this example, instead of the typical value of 0.05 that we use. And we'll go ahead and do a two-tailed test, which will allow for either a positive or a negative correlation to exist. So once again, we'll use alpha of 0.01 in a two-tailed test. Now, if you think about it, before we begin the analysis, what type of relationship should we see, if we see any at all, between height and weight? Do you think that the taller people are, they tend to also weigh more? Or would it be the taller they are, they tend to weigh less? Well, it should make sense that taller people tend to weigh more. There's certainly many exceptions, but that's the general pattern. And people who aren't as tall tend to weigh less. So, what type of correlation should that be, positive or negative? That should be a positive correlation, right? Because higher scores on X are associated with higher scores on Y. Or, in this example, taller people tend to also weigh more. People who aren't as tall tend to weigh less. So let's go ahead and run this analysis. We'll go to Analyze, and then select Correlate, and then Bivariate. And once again, bivariate just means two variables. And then when you do that, you see the Bivariate Correlations dialog box opens. Let's go ahead and move our variables over to the Variables box. And then notice Pearson is selected by default. That's what we want to run once again. We have a two-tailed test. We'll allow significant correlations to be flagged. And that means the asterisks that you saw in the previous video. Everything looks good here, so let's go ahead and click OK. And we see our output here in the viewer window. And if you recall from the last video, we want to see where our two variables intersect or meet. So we have height and weight here. Notice the correlation between height and weight is 0.68, rounded to two decimal places. And we have a p-value of 0.001. And we'll go ahead and use the same decision rule as always. In this example, we'll be using alpha of 0.01. So we're going to compare our p-value to the following two conditions to see which of the two it falls into. So with a p-value of 0.001, you should see here that it falls into this first condition. P is less than or equal to 0.01. Notice that this is 1/10 smaller. It's 0.001. Where this is 0.01. Okay, so this is the case here. P is less than or equal to 0.01. So that indicates that the test is significant, meaning that there is a significant relationship between height and weight. So the correlation is significant, and you want to note if it's positive or negative. It is a positive correlation, as we see a value of 0.68 reported. There's no negative sign here, and that makes sense, because taller people tend to weigh more. So we have a positive correlation of 0.68. So next we'll write our results using APA format. And the written results are as follows. There is a significant positive relationship between height and weight. Recall that we're using the Pearson R correlation here. So we have R and then 18 degrees of freedom, which once again, while they're not reported in this table, they're equal to n minus 2. So if n is 20, the degrees of freedom are equal to 20 minus 2, or 18. And then we have a correlation of 0.68, and that's positive. And finally, our p-value is equal to 0.001. And as always, if preferred, you can report p is less than or equal to alpha, which in this case is 0.01, instead of reporting the exact p-value, if desired. However, as always, it's recommended to report the exact p-value, as it really is more informative than just less than 0.01. Next, let's take a few moments to produce a scatter plot. So to do that, we'll go to Graphs, and then Legacy Dialogues, and then select Scatter Dot. Simple Scatter is selected by default, and that's what we want, so go ahead and click Define. And then the Simple Scatter Plot dialog box opens. We can go ahead and move height to the y-axis, and then weight to the x-axis, and then click OK. SPSS produces our scatter plot, and you can see here, if these points are well represented by a straight line on this plot, the way it's shown, our line would look something like, would go about right here, more or less, through here, but a straight line does do a good job at representing these data points. This concludes the presentation on correlation in SPSS. Thanks for watching.